Hello everybody, welcome to your new session. Today we are going to discuss about a PDF report generation using a cucumber runner class. Okay, so PDF report can be generated using a cucumber runner class, and there is another way of generating a cucumber PDF report using cucumber.json file. So if you want to generate with the help of that cucumber.json file, also you can generate it. So in that case, it will be, you have to write a separate class, and that class will contain converting that JSON into a PDF. There are so many jars available. One of them is HTML to PDF, which is a jar, very good jar, which can be used. Okay. So in this session, we are going to use a cucumber runner class to generate a report. So what jar you need it? Basically, you need a cucumber runner jar. Any version you can take it. I have taken the latest version. You can take any other versions. You can download from this group ID. Okay. In normal way, what we do generally, we run our cucumber class with a cucumber.class. So run with cucumber.class. In that case, what happened? We generate multiple type of report, pretty HTML report, JSON report, JUnit report, coverage report, rerun.txt file. So these are the type of report we generated. So in our case, right now what we are going to do it, we are generating PDF report. So to generate a PDF report, what you need to run with extended cucumber.class, and then another annotations, extended cucumber option. Okay. So these two things are needed. So what parameter we are passing? We are passing a parameter called cucumber.json. So this is JSON will get generated at the time of executions. And retry zero means your failed test cases will not execute one more time. If you give one, it will run once, and if the fail is there, then it will again try to run the same test cases. Okay. So these are the type of report will get generated. So based on your requirement, which one you need it, you give true false, even though you can delete the parameter itself. So parameter is a JSON format. You can see it. It's a JSON format totally. Then we have a users report, which we are generating it. So that report also true false, we are giving it. Screenshot, if you have embedded a screenshot into your HTML report, same you can embed into your PDF report also. Size, you can give size of a screenshot. Then PDF true false also you can give. If you give false, it will not generate the PDF, it will generate only the HTML reports. Okay, so that's the reason I'm taking a json.file from the target to and generating a report into the target folder to distinguish separately. Like distinguish means one place I'm generating a HTML report, which is a normal report, another I'm generating a PDF report along with some HTML report. How it works basically is first generate the HTML report and then convert that HTML into the PDF. This is how internally it's working. So with the help of cucumber.json, it's generating the HTML report and then it is converting into the PDF report. So what are the reports you need? You can give it here. Okay, now I have three test cases. Basically, in this scenario, I have two test cases. In this annotation, I have one test cases. This is parameterized one. So let's run and generate the report first. Okay, so in this case, what I'm doing it, I'm going into the automation practice.sites. I'm logging in and then going to the my account and logging out. So in first scenario, you can see it is trying to log in with an wrong passwords and authentication is failing. It will wait for 10 seconds because I have given synchronization time 10 seconds for the next element to be visible. So next element is not visible into the my account, so it will fail the test cases. Then it is going to execute the two more scenarios. One of the scenarios is like logging into the application and go to the dashboard and log out. Another is application, go to the my account and log out. These two scenarios it will execute. So these two will pass and one will fail. So we can have both pass and fail scenarios into the HTML PDF report. So to see how the pass test case has been reported and how the fail test case has been reported in the generated PDF. Okay, now the PDF will get generated. Okay. Okay, so we can go to the folder to see the PDF has been generated. Yes, two folder have been generated. One is target, So you can see normal HTML report will generate, has you can see it with the help of any of the browsers. Just taking time. I can open in a Chrome also. You can see it. So one test case has got failed. So I have embedded the fail snapshots and also the screenshots and the two scenarios which has passed. You can see it. Okay. These are two scenarios and these are the two. Okay. Now go to the next folder. I told you as I'm generating the target folder, you can see all the HTML is getting generated. Now you can go to the your reports. So this is the result overview. We can have pass fail percentage, two pass one fail. So feature wise, one feature file in one pass one fail, 50-50. Scenario wise, three scenarios, two pass one fail. So you can see it, one feature file, two scenario, four steps, all details are here. Now if you go to the another report, this is overview chart report. Okay, it does not contain anything. Then there is result. So here it is pass and fail. Fail also is coming. You can navigate into the menu, sort of menu it is, bookmark also. So it will generate the reports here. You can see pass, fail, everything. So it's a nice report. No need to include CSS and all. Directly copy the PDF and send to any of the reports. So what is the basic advantage of this report is you have a users report also, how many is the users and all. The advantage is when in the case of HTML you need to include the image and CSS and all along with the HTML file, but in case of PDF, even though it's a file is very large, you can just send it because it takes less space compared to your HTML reports. Okay, so big projects you can create a PDF report and you can send it to someone and it's look very elegant. Basically you can see it, any other report if you see this fast, you can see that it's look very elegant compared to our HTML reports. Okay. So thank you for watching my videos.